subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.
You're watching Tag TV.
India is well known around the world owing to its historical background, diverse cultures and interesting traditions. Its ancient scriptures and texts have been the way of life of its people for thousands of years. Today, the country is taking huge strides in various fields like arts and science, paving a way towards a progressive India. So friends, I'm your host Shreyasa Vijay, and today in our episode of My India, we'll take a look at some of the stories that very well showcase the unique culture and prosperity of our country stretching from Himalayas to Kanyakumari. India is a rich repository of art and culture, and a village in Odisha's Puri district is a living example of this heritage. Said to be the land of artisans, the village's every individual is an artist and every house is a studio. So today, we take you to this artisan village of Raghurajpur to witness the living workshop of handicraft.
As one enters Raghurajpur, a village in Odisha's Puri district, an artist is found at every doorstep. There are around 154 families in this village whose generations have spent their entire lives making handicrafts. Every single child in this village is an artist by virtue of his birth.
मैं तो जब से छोटा हूँ वो देख के आ रहा हूँ, सब दादो दादा सब बनाते हैं यहाँ पे, सब देख के अभी भी सीख गया हूँ, ट्रेनिंग लिया हूँ.
There are over 9 types of handicrafts made over here, like wooden toys, stone carvings, palm leaf painting, paper mache, among which Patta Chitra tops the list. This ancient art form is made over a piece of cloth or a dried palm leaf known as Patta, which is first painted with a mixture of chalk and tamarind seed gum. Then the surface is painted with colorful and intricate pictures of various gods, goddesses and mythological scenes with ornamentation of flowers, trees and animals. Using tamarind seed gum instead of other chemical gums helps in preserving the painting for decades.
ये सारे इमली ऐसे इसीलिए हम लोग यूज करते हैं क्योंकि पुराने जमाने में ये कोई गम की केमिकल वगैरह ये सब नहीं था और इमली का बीज को पुराने जमाने में ये लोग रिसर्च करके देखा कि इसमें कीड़ा मकड़ा कुछ नहीं लगता है, ये पूरा ट्रेडिशनल प्रोसेस से होता है.
अंसारी पट्टा पेंटिंग्स आर क्रिएटेड फॉर द पीपल टू वर्शिप ड्यूरिंग द पीरियड ऑफ फोर्टनाइट व्हेन इट इज बिलीव दैट गॉड्स फॉल सिक. These Patta paintings give a unique identity to the village and artisans of Raghurajpur. In 2000, Raghurajpur also became the first village in the state to be given the status of heritage village by the Indian National Trust for Art and Cultural Heritage (INTECH). Later, the village was developed as a crafts village with murals on the walls of artist houses, which makes it look like a living museum. Today, the village is visited by a number of tourists who want to indulge in traditional crafts, which help in improving the economic status of the villagers.
First, this is like a unique place, you know. Every single household is involved in making this beautiful art. And it's not just Pottachitra, they also have those paper mache, if you see the, birds and all those things. I think it is unique. And I think the state government is trying to promote this kind of art, which is why they've named it as a heritage village. And so now how I got to know it, about it is through a Google search. You know, so then obviously that means, you know, they're trying to promote it.
In Raghurajpur, talent is born and nurtured in every single household. Every villager here deeply believes in the fact that they are born in this world to create magic with their fingers and imagination.
Service to humanity is service to God. This is what the tradition of setting up community kitchens teaches us, in which free meal is served to hundreds and thousands of people. Besides serving humanity, the tradition is well known for breaking the barriers of caste and creed and keeping up with the age-old tradition of our country that are based on love and compassion for all. Presently, when coronavirus has given a huge blow to humanity, people across India are coming together and setting up these kitchens to feed thousands of hungry souls. India's charitable mega kitchens have come to the rescue of thousands of underprivileged people amid the coronavirus pandemic. With nationwide lockdown announced by the Prime Minister to contain the spread of virus, the decision seems to be hitting hard the underprivileged section, who is finding it difficult to have at least one meal a day. So doing the needful at these hard times are the community kitchens, who rising above polarization are coming together to help those in need during the pandemic. In Mumbai, Mohammadi Kitchen, which was once started with a purpose to feed the people of their own community, is now serving thousands of poor people irrespective of caste and community. The volunteers maintain proper hygiene while preparing food, and proper precautionary measures like wearing gloves and mask are taken into account.
हमारी अपील यही है कि जो जहां रहे, जो देश में रहे, उस देश की बिगर भेदभाव किए हुए, जात-पात के भेदभाव किए बिगर हर जगह पे अपने को अपना सहयोग देना चाहिए. जहाँ भी रहते हैं हम, जो भी कंट्री में रहते हैं, वो कंट्री में ये भेदभाव छोड़ के सबकी सेवा करनी चाहिए. और मेरी अपील पूरे समाज से है कि हर तबके के जो भी है, जितने भी है बड़े, उनको यही है कि भाई साथ मिलके हर एक लिए, हर इंसान के लिए हमको मदद करनी चाहिए और अपना मदद करके उनको मानवता को, जो आदमी को जिस वक्त अभी ज़रूरत है, वो उसकी ज़रूरत पूरी हो सके और अपना बराबर का उनको हर चीज़ मिल जाए.
Similar scenes can also be observed in Thiruvananthapuram, where around 25 community kitchens have been functioning under the Thiruvananthapuram Corporation since the government has announced the lockdown. These kitchens are being run by a number of volunteers who together work to provide food to around 67,000 people.
We are providing food for all the needy destitutes as well as the palliative patients and all those who require food. We are providing it into their houses itself. You know that in each and every ward there are 20 volunteers. Food packets are packed by themselves and they are also serving to the persons who are required the food packets. And we are also functioning. Three camp are there, which are all that beggars and all the persons who are in the streets were taken into that places and we are providing food.
At present, when the whole country is under coronavirus lockdown, in such a situation, a number of people cutting across the religious lines are coming forward and extending their helping hand to those in need. Now, a roundup of some of the major stories that made news recently. India illuminated its iconic monuments with oil lamps on World Heritage Day to express solidarity to those working hard amid the ongoing countrywide lockdown imposed to curb the spread of the coronavirus. The World Heritage Day is observed on April 18th with an aim to create awareness among the people for conservation of cultural heritage across the world. The iconic Red Fort, Qutub Minar, Humayun's tomb, monuments in New Delhi were illuminated with oil lamps and candles on this day to honor police, medical staff and other workers battling at the front line to contain the deadly virus.
हमारे जो वॉरियर्स हैं, कोरोना वॉरियर्स हैं, जितना हमारा पुलिस स्टाफ है, मेडिकल स्टाफ है, उनको सपोर्ट देने के लिए, उनको सपोर्ट करने के लिए हमने ये प्रज्वलन दिया, प्रज्वलन का प्रोग्राम रखा है। ये हमारे कुतुब मीनार में, लाल किला में, हुमायूं टॉम में, हम लोगों ने तीनों जगह में करा है कि जो आज समय इतना मेहनत का काम कर रहे हैं उनको सपोर्ट करने के लिए।
Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi extended a lockdown of India's 1.3 billion population till 3rd May as the number of coronavirus cases spiked despite a three-week shutdown announced last month. Artists in Ranchi city have come up with their own way of creating awareness about coronavirus with a painting and urge people to stay at home to prevent the pandemic from spreading further. A green and red colored painting of coronavirus depicted as a monster was made in the middle of a road aimed at scaring lockdown violators and make them aware of the repercussions that the disease can have on the country.
बहुत सारे लोग ऐसे हैं जो कि नहीं मान रहे हैं, उस उनको इस डर से बेखौफ है और हमने इसी चीज़ को इस पेंटिंग में दिखाया है कि कोरोना वायरस एक महाराक्षस महामारी के रूप में है जो कि एक तरह से नहीं कितने तरह से हम पे अटैक करता है, हमको ग्रसित कर सकता है और हमको बहुत ज़्यादा नुकसान होगा। इसलिए इस चीज़ों से बचने के लिए हम लोग मैसेज दिए कि कम से कम इसको देख कर लोग समझे और घर में रहे।
Nowadays, a number of artists across the country are coming with new creative ideas to create awareness among people about the coronavirus pandemic. Next, we move to our section of AsiaBuzz, where today we will get indulged in the skillful artworks of Japan, where one artwork can give a new lease of life to worn-out books. The other has become a source of entertainment for almost all age groups. We have a report.
This damaged book that looks like it should be thrown away is soon going to get a new life. Mr. Nobuo Okano has been working for over 30 years in a rare profession of repairing worn out books.
修理を依頼する本っていうのは大事にしてる本、なおかつ頻繁に使ってる本ですので、ページが取れてきたり、それから最初のページの方がこう破けてきた、こういう状態ですと大事にしてる本がかわいそうになって、あるいは使いにくくなって、それでは修理を頼もう、修理をしようということで依頼が来ます。
This shop is close to the famous second-hand books market in Tokyo. Many people who buy old books here want to give their books second life by bringing them to Okano's shop. Some customers even come to him to learn the craft of fixing old books.
自分の本が壊れてた時に、ちゃんと本の形になってれば読めるのに読めなくて残念だなと思って、
One of the many steps to repair a book is to unfold the pages and press them to original form. This painstaking process shows how much care and time is required for repairing a book, as the pages in this process are to be pressed one by one. The time that is needed to fix a book varies depending on the damage. However, a book that is severely damaged can usually take up several days or more to repair. Books are very unique items with their content playing a major role. So they should have a good cover, and thus the craftsman pay a lot of attention while putting a cover so as to make sure that the content remains protected for years.
その本を直すときに、持ち主、所有者の気持ちになって、大事な本だから、きれいに直そうっていう、依頼通りに思い入れがあるものを丁寧に直してあげようっていう、そういう気持ちになってきます。
Precious books, no matter how damaged, can find a new life at this store. This intricate samurai figure is created entirely from folded paper. This art form is known as origami that has originated from Japan. This piece of art can be found at Origami Kaiken in Ochano Mizu in Tokyo.
世界の人たちが折り紙を楽しもうと。その折り紙もですね、ゲームじゃなくて本当の歴史から入って、それからどうやって紙が作られて色を染める工場とかね、そんなもので長く皆さんだから20年30年の人たちが長くうちに見えるかゆう快感なんです。
Origami began in temples where the paper was folded in a special way to be presented as a token of appreciation to the god. It then became a form of entertainment and games for a variety of ages as it was taught in schools. Today, origami has become a huge inspiration for a variety of fields such as medical appliance and origami engineering, which is applicable to architecture or aeronautical engineering. Visitors can come and enjoy a range of experience as well as learn the process of creating origami.
This shop is just a world of encouragement and creativity and his love of the art that he does. He is a true artist. And I'm so privileged and honored to be here.
There is also a paper dyeing studio that visitors can view and see how paper used for origami is dyed.
全国の和紙の産地から仕入れているんですけど、厚い紙、薄い紙、それから染みる紙、染みない紙がありますので、ハケで全面に染めたりとか、全部つけてしまって染めたりとか、上からいろんな色をかけてぼかしたりとか、いろんな染め方があります。
This huge range of origami paper gives people the ability to be as creative as they like. Many items in the museum are exhibited to give inspiration to those who are interested in learning more about this beautiful art.
作ったものが動物とかね、そうですね、ウサギとかね、みんなできた、できる。それは言葉はいらないですね。そしてできたものにみんながわかります。年齢、性別を問わないですね。こんな素晴らしい問題ですね。みんなが、だから僕は英語が喋れなくても海外に一人で行っても相手を感動させることができるのはやっぱり折り紙の持つ力です。
Origami is a Japanese art form that can bring people together from all over the world.
Mutual tolerance and regards for the belief of other religions is the essence of Indian society. Displaying one such example of this religious unification is a village in Faizabad district of Uttar Pradesh, where love and harmony among different communities prevails in every corner. Take a look.
At one side where Hindus are seen ringing the temple bells, on the other side Muslims sitting inside Dargah are offering their prayers to Allah. This is not the description of two different places, but of one place with two different religions entering into full communion with each other. Located in the small village of Faizabad district in Uttar Pradesh, this Hanuman temple and mosque are built in the same compound, spreading the message of religious unity and brotherhood. The praying grounds of the holy places are built next to each other, and members from both the communities have been cooperating with each other so as to prevent any religious strife.
जैसे नमाज का टाइम फिक्स होता है कि इतने बजे से जब नमाज है, उतने टाइम नमाज होती है, उसके बाद बाकी टाइम में पूजा होती है। जैसे कोई टाइम मंगल के दिन हुआ, कोई लड़के प्रोग्राम करते हैं मंदिर में, जब नमाज हम शुरू करते हैं तो ढोल बजाना बंद कर दें, साउंड बंद हो जाता है, और थोड़ी देर के लिए हम नमाज पढ़ के चले जाते, फिर अपना बजा लेते हैं। आपस हमारा सब एकदम बना हुआ है।
It is not just the temple and mosque where this communal harmony is seen, but the whole village is believed to be keeping this tradition alive since ages. Even during an upkeep of peace in 1992, when the neighboring town of Ayodhya was going up in flames due to communal rights, the people of this village refused to employ any security force here.
नहीं, हमारा तो तालमेल सबसे एक ही, हम लोग साथ ही रहते थे, साथ ही शुरू में पले बड़े हैं और खेलते भी हैं, एक दूसरे के त्योहारों में भी साथ शरीक होते हैं, तो इसीलिए हम लोगों का भी सोच वैसे ही है जैसे पुराने लोगों का था।
Thus, the way in which this village has kept its tradition of oneness alive, even during tough times, clearly shows that no other religion is greater than the religion of humanity.
Amid the COVID-19 outbreak, the demand for masks and sanitizer is touching new highs. And with this surge in demand, the price amount is also shooting up across the country, with quality getting compromised. So, in order to cope up with this situation, a few innovators and designers are coming with low-cost, good quality masks to make them both affordable and available for people, especially belonging to lower income class.
With the number of cases of coronavirus rising each day in the country, more and more number of people are wearing masks that has reportedly led to a shortage and therefore a rise in the price of the commodity. The prices of good quality masks are shooting up to 500 in the country, making it very difficult for the people with lower wages to afford it. So coming with a solution to tackle with this problem, an assistant professor, Bipin Kumar from Indian Institute of Technology, came up with the idea of making cheap masks to make it accessible for all the people of the country. Named as Kavach, the price of the mask is comparatively low as compared to other masks that range between 100 to 500.
Kavach is the initiative done to help our massive population, give them the maximum protection from our indigenous textile technologies. So in Kavach, we are using the right kind of raw material and best fitting design so that it can give you the maximum protection at a very, very affordable price.
Meanwhile, a popular fashion designer, Sadia Mufti, who is also the owner of Hankers, a boutique in Srinagar city of Jammu and Kashmir, is also helping the country in its battle against COVID-19. Mufti's boutique prepares thousands of masks every day for health workers, NGOs and local Kashmiris. She even distributes many of the masks free of cost. Moreover, Mufti's triple-layered masks have been approved for mass production by the experts in Kashmir Valley hospitals.
कुछ दिन पहले मैं अपने घर के लिए, अपनी फैमिली के लिए, अपने वर्कर्स के लिए मार्केट में मास्क खरीदने गई थी, तो मैंने देखा काफ़ी शॉर्टेज है और काफ़ी हाई रेट पे मिल रहे हैं, अगर मास्क मिल भी रहे हैं, और काफ़ी देखा कि लोग बहुत परेशान हैं, वायरस फैल रहा है, क्योंकि एक बहुत मेजर सेफ्टी है मास्क पहनना जब भी आप घर से बाहर जाएँ, किसी भी दूसरे इंसान से कम्युनिकेट करें। इस चीज़ को ध्यान रखते हुए मैंने अपने वर्कशॉप पर पहले एक सैम्पल बनाया मास्क का और देखा कि वो है, सही बन रहा है कि नहीं, क्योंकि मैंने 3-लेयर्ड मास्क बनाया है कॉटन का, जो कि वॉशेबल है, आप इसको पहनकर दोबारा धोकर आप इसको यूज़ भी कर सकते हैं और किसी हद तक, कहीं ना कहीं हद तक एयर को स्टॉप करता है अंदर आने के लिए। और इस चीज़ को इनिशिएट करने के लिए मैंने ये सोचा क्यों नहीं थोड़ी सी हेल्प की जाए सोसाइटी के लिए।
There are number of people like Kumar and Mufti across the country who are helping in the mass production of triple layered masks serving their own bit in the fight against novel coronavirus.
That's all we have for you this week. Your comments and suggestions are important to us. Do give us your feedback at myindia@anin.com. I'm your host Shreyasa Vijay, and it's goodbye from the entire production team.
Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.